Joining us now to talk more about the McChrystal controversy is Gwendolyn Jackson, who is a political analyst and also a former military prosecutor. Everyone is asking tonight, Gwen, why did General McChrystal even think that he could get away with saying something like this about the president and his staff?
Well, you know, my best guess is that perhaps, you know, the general was trying to find out what the climate was, you know, amongst the troops. What commanders generally do is they conduct unit climate profiles. They want to find out what the troops are thinking. And, you know, war is very stressful. This is a very stressful situation. He has a lot of constraints, and he's got a timeline to meet. Mm-hmm. So that could have been one of the reasons, but it's not acceptable behavior. But I can certainly kind of understand how this might have gotten out of hand. He might have been listening to the troops and, you know, to his staff
right.
members.
Well, now, you were in the military. You're a former prosecutor in the military. I mean, there's certain protocol that a general has. There are also some other avenues that he could take before something like this was published. Is that right?
Absolutely. I mean, this is unprecedented, and this is something that, you know, was a very poor decision, and it's unheard of. I mean, to publicly air these teachable issues or these gripes or even, you know, these in these staff meetings, I mean, it could compromise national security to have this person from Rolling Stones magazines involved with, you know, the intricate details running of the war and hearing, you know, these complaints. I think it was very inappropriate, especially when you consider the fact that Rolling Stones magazine, you know, they make money off sensationalism, okay? Well, and how was this person cleared? I mean, and there are other issues concerning whether this individual, this reporter, betrayed the trust of the general. I mean, I think we need to look at that as well.
Well, that's something that's probably going to come out later on. But do you think that this is what the president might call a teachable moment?
Well, I think for the general it's a teachable moment, but I think the president would have never suspected that these kinds of significant gripes, you know, was something that was going on. And certainly I think he was looking at the maturity level of the commanding general to set the proper tone to make sure that this didn't happen. Clearly, if there was going to be an article published, the general should have seen it before it was published. And, you know, there are certain things that should not have been aired for the security of the mission
right.
in front of a reporter for Rolling Stones.
Right. Gwendolyn Jackson, we thank you very much for joining us tonight.
Stay connected with MyFoxNY.com mobile. Download the iPhone app or text Fox 5 to 46988 for other devices. Local news, weather, and traffic on the go with MyFoxNY.com mobile.